inner workings of wastewater treatment is not something that many people understand. Many people often turn their nose up whenever you tell them that you work in the wastewater treatment field. But yet, it's a field that's imperative to the protection of the public health as well as our waterways. Often the stigma that's associated with wastewater treatment is based on a misunderstanding of just what all goes into wastewater treatment. Many have no understanding of even the basics that go in the way we effectively treat the wastewater. With a better understanding of these methods, I believe that we can change the thought process that wastewater treatment is an unappealing field to work in. So during this discussion, what I'm going to do is we're going to talk about the three basic ways that wastewater is treated and how they intertwine with one another. To begin, what we'll look at is the physical portion of wastewater treatment. Physical separations of solids in the water is the first step to effectively treating wastewater. We do this by a few different methods. When the wastewater first comes into the plant, we do a screening step where we take out the rags, brown paper towels, things of that nature. Then it moves on to the grit removal process, which removes rocks, sand, eggshells, and then finally to the sedimentation tanks, which remove any remaining suspended and settled solids. These are all methods that we use in the physical part. When we talk about sedimentation tanks, it's been like confused some in how they actually work. I found an article in the Encyclopedia Britannica, and it gives this definition for sedimentation tanks. It says a sedimentation tank allows suspended particles to settle out water and wastewater as it flows through the tank, thereby providing some degree of purification. Sedimentation tanks are actually among some of the oldest ways to treat wastewater, dating back to the Mesopotamian Empire between 3500 and 2500 BC, according to the article Wastewater Management Through the Ages. The second step after we've done the physical part of wastewater treatment is called the biological part. Biological treatment is accomplished when organic material in the wastewater, known as sludge, is mixed with the water that is filled with microbiological organisms that actually consume the organic material in the water. This mixture together is known as activated sludge. And according to the Introduction to Wastewater Treatment Grades 1 and 2 from the Fleming Training Center, it's the heart of the biological treatment process. Essential system functions include biological reactors where the microbiological organisms are fed oxygen to remove organics, and then secondary clarifiers or sedimentation tanks where the remaining settable material is removed. And then the third and final step in the treatment process is chemical treatment and then release. Chemical treatment, known as disinfection, is the primary way of destroying all pathogenic microorganisms before release into receiving waters. So essentially the same microorganisms that we use to treat the wastewater help to remove the organic materials also can be detrimental to life in the receiving streams. There are many different methods that we use for disinfection. They include chlorine, UV disinfection, and ozone disinfection, just to name a few. The main reasons we disinfect treated water, wastewater, is to protect public water supplies, fisheries and shellfish waters, irrigation and agricultural waters, and waters where human contact is likely to occur. So to conclude, wastewater treatment is something that never should be taken lightly. The protection of our water supplies depends heavily on proper maintenance and treatment through a wastewater plant. By providing a basic understanding of the process of treating wastewater, we can help the public to understand that the importance of this job and possibly recruit better operators into a rewarding and vital career.